clear as the daytime of the sun. Unless it's clear to you that he's a pakka kafir. Proof. See, if you, it's not fard to call a kafir. It's not fard. Even if the Muslim may be a kafir, why are giving a fatwa? Takfir. One calling another kafir outside the fold. So the various fatwas describing it is wrong. Now, as I mentioned, as far as calling the word Salafi, there are two groups of scholars. One group of scholars say it is fard. And I give you an example of Sheikh Nasiruddin Albani. I want to even let you know that Sheikh Saleh Fawzan, who I respect, he is the scholar of the present time, even he says calling Salafi is a fard. To a lesser extent, not very staunch, is Sheikh Bin Baz. He says, fine, to identify yourself, no problem. But there are other group of scholars who say calling Salafi is wrong. Scholars who believe in Quran, Hadith, and Salafi Salihin. First, I will quote you the person who's respected the most amongst the Salafis of the present time, Sheikh Ibn Taymiyyah. There's a book called The Call to Islam and the Caller, in which 40 hadiths are mentioned. The 40th hadith, the last hadith, is a hadith in which it is mentioned. It's hadith of Tirmidhi, hadith number 2600. There it is said that Allah's Messenger, Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, said that I have been instructed with five things which I'm instructing to you. First is Jama'ah. First is Jama'ah. Jama'ah means following the three generation, the Salaf is following. Second is obeying. Third is hearing. Fourth is Hijrah. And fifth is Jihad in the way of Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. First is Jama'ah, following Salaf is following. Second is hearing. Third is obeying. Fourth is Hijrah. Fifth is Jihad in the way of Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. Five things. And anyone who goes away by a span's difference from the Jama'ah, he has thrown the yoke of Islam off his neck. And anyone who calls to anyone besides Allah, he is inviting you to the abode of hellfire. Hadith, classified as Sahih. Sheikh Ibn Taymiyyah says, after this hadith, in this book, that one of the Salaf, the pious predecessors, he said, that I don't know on which of the two things should I thank Allah more, for bringing me to Islam or for keeping me away from the innovators. One of the Salaf, he quotes and he says, I don't know which of the two things should I thank Allah more, for bringing me Islam, for me becoming a Muslim, or for keeping me away from the innovators. You should call yourself only, even in the previous hadith of Tirmidhi, it ends by saying, if you call anything besides the way of the Allah, what Allah has called you, and he says, Muslim, Mu'min, and Abdullah. A Muslim, a believer, and the worship of Allah. If you call anything besides these three things to yourself, you're calling yourself to hellfire. Hadith. This Salaf, Sheikh Ibn Taymiyyah quotes, that if you call anything, I don't know which thing should I thank more for Allah, for bringing me Islam or for keeping me away from the innovators. You cannot call anything besides what Allah has called you in the Quran. Muslim, Mu'min, and Abdullah. Sheikh Ibn Taymiyyah. So how can you quote saying Sheikh Ibn Taymiyyah says you call yourself Salafi? What Sheikh Ibn Taymiyyah says, you have to follow the Salafi solo in which even I say. Sheikh Ibn Taymiyyah never said call yourself Salafi. I'm quoting you another scholar, Sheikh Utaimi. Now see, all these scholars are stalwarts of the present time. All three expired now. Sheikh Nasruddin, Sheikh Bin Baz, Sheikh Utaimi. In the book of Until When Will We Differ, there's a book of Sheikh Utaimi. It's available there in the exhibition. Until When Will We Differ, on page number 36. An Indian asks Sheikh Utaimi a question. In my country, people call towards Ikhwani and Tablighi. Are they on truth or falsehood? Sheikh Utaimi gives the reply. If anyone calls himself as Ikhwani, calling towards Ikhwani, Tablighi or Salafi, he is on falsehood. The question of Salafi wasn't there. Sheikh Uthaymi goes out of his way to say that anyone calls himself a Ikhwani, a Tablighi, or a Salafi, calling towards him, it is on falsehood, not I. See, Dr. Zakir Naik is nothing in Islam. I am zero. Sheikh Uthaymi, mashallah, has a caliber. So I am following the fatwa of Sheikh Uthaymi. So any Salafi who points a finger at me will have to point the finger at Sheikh Uthaymi. Now all these people on the website, you go, they even say Sheikh Uthaymi says call us a Salafi. What he says? Sheikh Uthaymi says you should follow the Salafi Salih. But that even I say. So Sheikh Uthaymi does not mind anyone following Salafi Salih. But if you call towards saying call yourself a Salafi, he says it is falsehood. Sheikh Uthaymi. So Sheikh Nasiruddin Albani is on one extreme, fard. Sheikh Uthaymi says it is wrong. But both agree. Sheikh Nasiruddin Albani also says that if you call yourself Salafi, thinking you're superior, then it is wrong. Sheikh Saleh Fawzan also says, if you say I'm a Salafi, I'm superior, then it is wrong. So even these first group of scholars who say calling Salafi is a fard, even they agree, if you call yourself Salafi and say that I'm superior, I will go to Jannah, others won't go, that is wrong. Sheikh Saleh Fawzan, Sheikh Nasiruddin Albani, Sheikh Bin Baz, Sheikh Uthaymi, saying this, he says you should not call yourself a Salafi. I am not as staunch as Sheikh Uthaymi. If you ask me, I said, preferably call yourself Muslim. If someone calls himself Salafi, in some cases can be Mubah. Fine, shortcut. I don't say it's haram. But I prefer safe, 100% safe Muslim. The scholars are differing. Should call or not call? If someone is calling as a shortcut, instead of saying, I follow Quran, Hadith, and Salafi Salih, only till that extent, which is not the case. Most of the people, they say, Salafi, saved sect. Means all the others go to Jahannam. So this way it is wrong. For short reason, if you say, I say Mubah, not a Fard, I am more with the fatwa of Sheikh Saleh Munajjid. Sheikh Saleh Munajjid says, if you call for understanding that you do not belong to the innovators, there is no problem. But if someone calls saying I'm a Salafi better, then it is wrong. And he quoted the hadith of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. That at the time of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam Medina, there was a fight between the Ansar and the Muhajirs. So the Ansar said, oh Ansar, come to me. So all the Ansars piled behind Ansar. And the Muhajir said, oh Muhajir, come help me. The Prophet came to know, he said, what is this call of Jahiliya? See, if you analyze, calling Ansar is not bad, calling Muhajir is not bad. But here they were making groups. Ansar, come and help me. Muhajir, come and help me. Prophet said it is the call of the Jahiliya. Though Ansar is a good name. Ansar means the helpers. Helpers of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Muhajir means those who migrated in the way of Allah and His Rasul. It's a good name, but yet the Prophet said it is haram to identify yourself, I'm superior. So based on this, I don't say Salafi is haram. Don't get me wrong. But absolutely safe is Muslim. If you say Salafi and have a little bit of error and, you know, ego and all, problem may go to the, may be dangerous, which the Prophet prohibited. Therefore, safe is call innani min al-Muslim and say that I'm a Muslim. Otherwise, I can say I'm a Pakka Hanafi, Pakka Shafi, Pakka Hamli, Pakka Malki, Pakka Salfi, Pakka Ahli Hadith, no problem. But in label, call yourself a Muslim. I would like to end my talk by giving the opinions in the ending of these great scholars, which will open up your mind. According those people who say takfir, no takfir, kafir, kafir, Imam Shafi, may Allah's mercy be on him, he said that if calling the names, attributes of Allah, what Allah has given is that. Anything else is haram, is kufr. You can only call to name of Allah what he and his messenger have given, nothing else. Anything else is kufr. But if someone calls another name in ignorance, then he's not a kafir, Imam Shafi. Sheikh Ibn Taymiyyah, you know what he said? He said, if someone prostrates to a man and he thinks this is his deen, then he's not an unbeliever. Sheikh Ibn Taymiyyah. If someone does shudud to a man, Sheikh Ibn Taymiyyah said, if someone does sajda to a man, to a human being and thinks it is his deen. He is not an unbeliever until someone explains to him, and yet he's on it. Sheikh Ibn Taymiyyah, what a great personality. Further, if you read Sheikh Shawkani, he said that if someone bows down to anyone besides Allah in ignorance, he is not an unbeliever. Muhammad ibn Wahab, may Allah's mercy be on him, he said that we do not call unbelievers to those people who bow on the idol of the grave of Abdul Qadir, or on the idol of the grave of Ahmad Badawi, or the likes of it. So how can we call unbeliever to those people who do not do shirk? We claim that we are knowledgeable, giving takfir, kafir, etc. I would like to end with the two hadiths of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in Sahih Muslim, volume number 3, hadith number 4565, that Arfaja, may Allah be pleased with him, he said that the Messenger that there will be a time when evil things will happen in a community, and whenever a person